Road rage. I'm not. Thankfully, I haven't had a bunch of moments where I can talk about it, but I did get in trouble once when someone threw an entire bag of Wendy's out of their window, and I did the no thing.
Oh, yeah.
And then the guy followed me for a little bit.
Yeah, and wagging your finger at somebody, that could piss them off. And who's throwing? I guess you wagged. They threw the groceries out, then you wagged the finger, then they followed you.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
Yep.
410-338-1098. There's a new show on Netflix coming out. It's called Beef. It starts Steven Yeun and Ali Wong, and it's about two people that become so obsessed over a road rage incident that it starts to consume their daily lives.
And over one incident?
Yeah, that's what it says. Something must have happened that really burned into their brain. And Steven Yeun says, I'm grateful to the guy who yelled at me in traffic 3 years ago. I didn't let it go, and now we have a show. And I'm wondering, anybody out on the road, it's been a strange couple, 3 years, people flying around in their cars. There's been more single-car fatalities, single-car accidents, because people are acting like they're on Daytona 500, especially when there was nobody on the road. And then you start letting people out of quarantine.
Yeah, there's been a big shift in styles.
Yeah.
I mean, people do drive aggressively here, but it's definitely changed since the pandemic. And 410-338-1098, if you want to text or call and tell us your road rage incidences.
And maybe you were somebody that road raged on somebody else because they did something to you and you felt like you had to retaliate.
Mm-hmm.
A ways back, I was headed to the beach, and I was with Girlie, my girlfriend at the time, and there was a car that, and I mentioned it before, they were going slow in the left lane, and so I dipped around and passed them on the right lane, pissed them off to no end. So now the guy jumped in front of me, and he tried to slow me down.
Wait, I mean, you were in the road, right? You weren't like on the shoulder or anything?
No. Yeah. He wanted to be the leader.
Yeah.
And didn't like the fact that I went and passed on the right and did it with a little speed. And then when I jumped back in front of him, he made sure that for the next 20 miles.
I've seen that.
He slowed down. He sped up. He slowed down. I looked in the car. He looked right at me like, what are you going to do? And then finally he zipped off Benfield Road or whatever. No, I know what it was. Not Benfield Road. The next one you come up, you can stay on 97 and go off to the left, or you can go on Route 3 and go off to the right. He went off to the right, and I thanked God.
Yeah.
Because it could have gotten ugly.
Yes.
Yeah. And, I called the police. I said, there's a guy, and I told them his license plate, and I said, if somebody else calls, this ain't the first call, because I'm calling you because this guy's being a D-bag.
Right. We have a friend in sales. I won't say who she is. And she said a woman was being crazy, yelling at her in her big, giant SUV. And so she gave her the finger, which is very out of character for this woman.
Oh!
And the lady lost it, followed her. So now she was anxious. And so she tried to drive to the nearest police station, which is a good move. And then after about 5 to 7 minutes, she gave up, left.
Yeah.
She figured scared her enough.
Well, you hope.
Immediately scary.
Yes. They could pull up the street and wait for you. And then, hey, remember me? I'm back.
Yeah, you know, recently I said there was a dog in a car on a hot day.
Uh-huh.
And several people said you should have smashed the window. And I said, you know, in this day and age, people have guns.
You could have got shot for smashing somebody's window.
110%.
Pay attention to your own life, dearie.
Yes.
Yeah.
People have guns and people use them. And that's why it's scary, because how many times do we get insanely mad? And if you had a weapon, you'd probably want to use it.
You might pull it out and use it, or if you feel like you're afraid.
Normal people that are not crazed, they're just in that heat of the moment where they're seeing red, you know?
Whereas we used to just fight. We'd pull over.
Maybe,
get out of the car and get to it. Somebody must have got cold feet. But, yeah, anybody out there that's been through something like that and doesn't mind sharing your road rage incident, 410-338-1098. Yeah, dreaming's free, but gas ain't free. It's Kirk and Marianne, along with producer Will Blake, 410-338-1098. There's a Netflix show coming up called Beef, which is all about road rage. And we're talking about road rage. A couple of callers on the line. And I just want to say, I have been guilty of road raging. Somebody jumps in front of me. I followed you close for a half mile, maybe a mile or two, before I peel off. Yeah. I'm not immune to it.
It can end ugly.
Yeah, it can.
And I always wonder, like, if somebody gives up, do you feel like, yeah, I won? Or is it...
You're looking behind you for a while.
Yeah. And then you go home and you don't really think about it anymore, so...
You don't?
Do you?
I was thinking about a TV show, but I'll... Or a movie or something about road rage, and I'll tell you about it in a minute.
All right, we've got... Let's see. First is Mike from Edgewood. Hi.
What's up, Mike?
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Good.
Good. What happened?
So, I'm on my way to work, and a car in front of me is probably doing 10, 15 miles under the speed limit, so it's... a little frustrating, whatever.
Yes. Yeah.
The truck behind me was even more frustrated, decided he wanted to go around me and that person in double solid yellow line, school area, kids all around, flew around me. Well, we go to the second stoplight. I just look at him, kind of shake my head. He rolled the window down, asked me if I had a problem.
Oh.
Well, I said, well, I mean, if you're asking, I'm just curious why you did that. And he said he ain't got time to wait for any of that stuff. And I told him, yeah, we're still sitting at the same stoplight.
Yes!
And he just shook his head and rolled his window up at me, I guess, because he didn't have anything else to say after that. But it was just nonsensical. Somebody's going to get hurt. Oh, yeah. One more thing. I told him somebody's going to get hurt. He said his exact words were, if somebody gets hurt, it must be their time for them to get hurt.
Oh, my.
Are you a big guy or average or intimidating?
I'm probably about 5'11", 180 pounds. So, I mean, I'm average.
What do you drive?
He was driving a green, brand new, like, Toyota Tacoma.
Yeah.
Ooh, but what are you in?
Oh, yeah. I was in a little white Toyota Corolla, you know, 38 miles to the gallon for my son and everything, you know, a little mom-mobile.
Right. My man said, well, if you're asking, I do have a problem. I like that.
I did. Ooh. I mean, he saw me shake my head at him, so I did have an issue with it.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, let him know.
Like
it didn't
you.
Do any different.
I like that, Mike. He's still shake your head.
Around.
At least you're okay. Yeah, nothing happened. Thanks, Mike.
Let's see. I'm going to go to... Dolly?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hi, did I see your name right?
Yeah, Dolly.
Nice.
Yeah, so I was going down the road, and I was in a section of the road where the right lane has to yield over into the left lane, and the left lane has the right of way.
Yeah.
Well, I was driving, and the guy next to me or whatever, you know, he was trying to get over, and, you know, I just kept on going. I wasn't letting him over or whatever, so I guess he got mad, and he flew around me in the opposite oncoming traffic, pulled over in the middle of the road in front of me, got out.
Oh, God.
As soon as he got out, like you said, you know, of course, you never know if somebody has the guns. Well, I had a .32 in my pocket, so I put that on my lap, and he literally came over and opened up my driver's side door, and I just stared up at him, and he looked at me, he was like, do you have a problem? And I just calmly looked down at my lap, looked back up at him, and said, I don't have a problem. Do you have a problem? And he looked at what I was looking at, and he just said, I'm good, and walked back to his car and left.
Oh, man, he was packing a .32 in his lap.
Dolly, what if he had a gun, and then you guys are in a standoff?
It's a duel now.
I'm just, at that point, it's his life or mine.
Yeah,
not worth it.
But Dolly's got the upper hand, because he's got the gun out. And I don't advocate
that. Mine was already in my lap. Like, I was in Edgewood. You know, I grew up in Edgewood. You never know. So I pulled it out, and I just sat it on my lap and was like, all right. Like,
is that on the sign for Edgewood? You just never know.
You never know.
You never know.
I'm riding with Dolly next time. Thanks, Dolly.
Thanks, Dolly.
All right, guys.
My man. He said, yeah, come on. What you want to do?
For the record, I think that would not be smart.
Look at my lap.
Leanne, hi.
Hey, guys.
What's up, girl?
All right, so we had kind of a tag team thing going on. We're driving up 97, and this guy cuts over in front of me and, like, slams on his brakes to brake check me.
Yeah.
And so my friend who was driving behind me seen him do it, so he sped up around the both of us, cut over in front of that guy, and brake checked him all the
way
to his exit.
It's like leapfrog or something.
Yeah. Then we boxed him in so he couldn't get over in the other lane.
Oh, boy.
That's dangerous right there, too.
Yeah, this is making me nervous.
It was, but we were teenagers.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
2 years ago.
You're excused, Leanne.
Thanks, Leanne.
Darn it. I cut her off.
Here's Mark.
And Mark from Abingdon. Hi.
Hi, Marianne. How you doing?
Good. Tell us your story.
My wife and my ex-wife got into an argument, and my wife wound up following her up the road and brake checked her, and then ended up in court in the state of Maryland. It's a second-degree assault charge to brake check somebody.
I didn't know that.
And, how do you prove that?
So there.
Well,
these two women
turned into basically a protective order.
You must have had the magic wand if the ex is fighting the present over you.
No, they just like to be a little crazy sometimes.
Got the protective order out.
You guys have a great one. Appreciate the time.
All right,
you too,
thank
Mark.
You.
See you, buddy.
410-338-1098. Tell us your road rage incident.